In June 2009, the nation's first Diverging Diamond Interchange, or DDI, opened in Greene County, Missouri. Located in Springfield at the interchange of Interstate 44 and Missouri 13, the DDI has two travel lanes in both directions and averages approximately 34,000 vehicles per day. Centered in a busy and tightly constrained area, the interchange services a nearby zoo, fairgrounds, a hotel, and two large shopping centers. Pedestrians and bicyclists are accommodated by an illuminated and protected median walkway. To reach the median, pedestrians must first cross onto an island and then onto the median. Before construction of the DDI, traffic flowed through a conventional diamond interchange. The spacing and location of the adjacent signals along Missouri 13 meant that during peak traffic, the signalized left turns onto the freeway would frequently back up into the through lanes.
Drivers wanted something done. Normal backup each day was about a mile. During event times, because we have the fairgrounds there, during event times we experienced at periods 2 to 3 mile backups.
The previous conventional diamond interchange had more conflict points than the new DDI. Before being converted, this particular interchange averaged over 100 crashes per year from 2004 through 2008. It also experienced heavy congestion.
The reason that the DDI is so much better than what was there before has to do with the amount of left turn storage that you have at the interchange itself. The left turn storage in the previous condition was only enough to store maybe about 1.5 semi-trucks. So the moment you got a queue of two trucks, it basically started to break down and interfere with the mainline through lanes. And that was the single biggest reason they needed a change at Missouri 13.
Before construction, the new interchange was computer simulated with estimated traffic volumes for the next 25 years.
We told the public we thought we'd see a 30 to 40% improvement in traffic flow.
The simulation showed a reduced delay ranging from 10 to 35% through to 2035. The Missouri Department of Transportation chose the DDI design because it didn't require a new bridge, could be completed in 6 months,
and at $3.2 million was one-third the cost of the next best alternative.
It wasn't very long we got into this thing, and we got through the engineering part and we're watching the VESA model, and I said, you know, I don't know that people understand this two-dimensional concept and make the public understand how that's going to work. So from that, he got the idea to hire this company to take the VESA model, a bunch of photos, 3D stuff, and we gave him all this information and the plan sheets, and the company built us a kind of a scaled 3D model of exactly what at least the initial plan sheet version of the DDI would look like. We spent a little over $20,000 on it, on a multi-million dollar project. It's probably the best $20,000 we ever spent, to be honest with you. I mean, you could take a group of people who were adamant that you were crazy for trying this, let them watch that video for 5 or 10 minutes, and probably 80 to 90% of them would go, you know what, I think that's going to work, and I think I understand it.
After the construction of the new DDI, a Missouri Department of Transportation survey showed that 95% of Springfield residents agreed the DDI resulted in a less congested roadway. The same survey showed that residents also considered the roadway easier to drive, better marked, and safer. Total crashes declined by 46%, and minor injury crashes decreased by 72%. The DDI also eliminated congestion on the bridge and significantly reduced the up to 3 mile long backups. The Federal Highway Administration encourages communities and agencies to consider the Diverging Diamond Interchange, both to improve the safety and efficiency of existing interchanges and as an option for new interchanges. For more information about the Diverging Diamond Interchange and other innovative intersection designs, please visit safety.fhwa.dot.gov.